Hi, in this video I will discuss the access control guidelines for cloud service models, and this video is based upon the NIST document, that is NIST special publication 800-210. So let's start. Now this is the general architecture of a cloud model. That is, at the bottom we have the hardware, and then upon this hardware we have the networking layer, storage layer, and upon that we have the hypervisor software. And now hypervisor software controls the virtual machines and it provides resources or the hardware resources to virtual machine. So the virtual machine include the operating system, the application programming interface, and upon the application programming interface we have different applications. So this is the cloud model from bottom to top. Now there are three different service model of providing cloud services to customers. So you can provide a service or the infrastructure as a service to a cloud customer, or you can provide platform as a service to a cloud customer, or you can provide software as a service to a cloud customers. So the infrastructure as a service is mainly for the IT administrator as a customer. So you can provide virtualized networking resources, virtualized storage, and maybe the access to hypervisor. And then the IT administrator may create their own virtual machines. So in platform as a service, this is basically for the software developers as a customer. So software developers are provided with a platform to develop their own applications. And then this software as a service is for normal application users. For example, if you want to use an email application, so this software as a service model is for those users. Now these are the same three service model, that is infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. So here you can see that the certain components are highlighted in yellow and certain are highlighted in blue. So the components which are highlighted in blue are controlled by the cloud customer in respective service model, and the components which are highlighted in yellow are controlled only by the cloud service provider. So this is the overview of the access control for cloud service models. So it implements a hierarchical restriction. So whatever is not allowed to the customer in infrastructure as a service model, since infrastructure as a service model has more rights for the customer and the software as a service has minimum rights for the customer. So whatever is not allowed or restricted to customer in infrastructure as a service model is also not allowed in platform as a service and software as a service. And similarly, whatever is not allowed to the customer in platform as a service is also not allowed in software as a service. Now this is the general software as a service model. So different applications are deployed by the cloud service provider, and you are just the users of these applications in software as a service model. And these applications may share similar resources in the backend, for example, a database. Now, in infrastructure as a service model, a customer may acquire two different cloud service providers, that is, infrastructure as a service from two different cloud service providers. So, now it is the responsibility of both cloud service providers to interoperate in order to provide transparent infrastructure as a service services to the customer. Now, the NIST document, that is 800-210, that is the special publication. So it has different tables with regards to the subjects and the objects they want to access, and what kind of access control or what kind of operations subjects can perform on objects. But I have rearranged this all data in a more meaningful fashion. So if a subject is an infrastructure as a service user and he wants to perform certain operations on the hypervisor, so he can log into the hypervisor and he can create new virtual machines, and he can read and write on those virtual machines, and he can adjust certain settings of hypervisor as well. Similarly, the infrastructure as a user, as a service user, can create, read and write the virtual machines as well. So if our subject is the virtual machine, then the virtual machine can perform certain actions on the hypervisor. So the virtual machine can write data or can update the hypervisor. So but only the configurations or the data which is associated with the virtual machine. Similarly, the virtual machine can read and write other virtual machines which is on the same physical host, that is same physical server. Moreover, the virtual machine can create, read and write the new guest operating system images. And similarly, the virtual machine can read and write to the VMs of different hosts within the same cloud service provider or within the different cloud service provider through interoperations between those two different cloud service providers. Now, with regards to the hypervisor, which is a software which is used to install or to manage the virtual machines. So the hypervisor can create new guest operating system images or can read and write the existing one. And with regards to the hardware resources, for example, the hardware networking and hardware storage or other processing power, a hypervisor can perform read and write operations on the hardware resources. And with regards to the VMs, a hypervisor can create new VMs and it can read and write to the existing one. And with regards to the application developer, and these application developers are the customer of platform as a service model. So here onward, in platform as a service model, the application developer can perform read, write and create operations on the middleware and also on the memory data of the virtual machine. Now the cloud service provider in platform as a service model can replicate the application data. So the cloud service provider can perform the backup operation on the application data in platform as a service model. Now the VMs of the hosted application or the virtual machine of the host in which the application is being hosted can perform read and write operation on the other application data on the same physical host. And the VMs of the hosted application can also execute the other application code in the same host. Now the application user can read the memory data related to its application in platform as a service model and also in software as a service model. And the application user can read and write application data. For example, you can read your own email and you can delete your own email as well. And with regards to the application code and the application user in software as a service model can execute the other applications. For example, if an email application has a link to other application inside the same email software, then the cloud user in software as a service model can execute that application as well. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected. Thank you.